What answer did you come up with, David? Is 2 the correct answer?
So I said that that was the correct answer. It looks to me like the relationships at play in frame A and frame C are the same, and the relationships at play in frame B and frame 2 are the same. We saw that X was unchanged between the two frames, just as R is, Y expanded, just as S does, and Z was deleted, just as T is. Similarly, Y was above X, just as S is above R. So I think it's the right answer.
Good, David. That's in fact the correct answer. 2 is the best choice available here. But imagine that for 2 as well, the match between the representation on the left side and the representation on the right side was only partial, just like it was when we had 5 on here. How then would we make a choice between 2 and 5, David?
So it sounds like so far we've been talking about kind of an all or nothing match of transformations. But if we didn't have an exact match between the transformations, we'd have to come up with some way to evaluate how well two transformations actually fit together. So we might say that these transformations are 95% similar, while these two are only 70% similar. So that would allow us to choose one over the other.
That sounds fair. In fact, we'll come across something like this very soon.